I rapimenti, i sequestri di persona a scopo di riscatto sono la nuova piaga della Siria in guerra. Succede anche qui, a Damasco, ogni giorno. Succede soprattutto nei quartieri cristiani, perché i cristiani sono i vasi di coccio tra i vasi di ferro. È successo qui, in questo negozio, dove George, un giovane di 23 anni, è stato rapito e da 17 giorni non dà più sue notizie. E la madre, i genitori, sono disperati.
At 2:30 p.m. he went to the shop to bring gold and cash money. Later my husband tried to call him on the telephone but he did not pick up. At 7:30 p.m. when I am at the store with my husband, my daughter calls me and tells me he has been taken by the rebels of the Free Army. I lost it right there. I ran out and started screaming in the middle of the road. They called me and they asked for 16 million liras and or they will cut him up in pieces. I begged them. I told them I would kneel before them, but please listen to me. I said, we cannot give you that kind of money. We don't have it. Then I heard his voice in the background screaming, Mom, Mom. He has been with them for 17 days now, and I'm losing my mind. I'm losing my mind. At first they asked me to find anti-aircraft weapons for them. In the end we found a mediator and offered $15,000. Yesterday they called back and said they want $50,000, not a cent less. Or... They even created a Facebook page with his picture and a thrilling look around his neck.
Poi, come se non bastasse, sul telefonino dei familiari arriva questo terribile filmato. Un filmato in cui George viene accusato di essere cristiano e frustato senza pietà.
My son has a tattoo of a cross on his left arm. Every time they call, they say they are going to cut his arm and send it to me. George used to sleep here. Lord, please make him return to me. Please make him come back home.
Secondo un documento di Medici Senza Frontiere, almeno 7.000-8.000 medici avrebbero abbandonato la Siria. Uno dei principali motivi che li spinge a lasciare il loro paese è la paura dei sequestri. I sequestri che colpiscono soprattutto i medici perché vengono considerati più ricchi, più agiati, più in grado di pagare il riscatto, come è successo a questo giovane dentista che siamo andati a incontrare qui a Damasco.
For work I had to go to an area between Aras and Douma. Some army groups came, they threatened everyone and took me away at gunpoint. The second day, after I gave them the contacts of my family, they came in and started shooting around my feet. If your family doesn't pay by tomorrow, we will kill you. They were all gutter boys from the slums. They were brainwashed. Some were between 13 and 16 years of age, but they were already holding Kalashnikovs. They were all rebels of the so-called Free Army. I knew right away because they had radios and drove me around on cars with their flags.
Tra le vittime dei rapimenti vi sono anche molti giornalisti.
My team and me, we were going to a tell city.
My crew and I were going to Al-Talal, a small town 10 kilometers away from Damascus, and the rebels of the Free Army stopped our car and kidnapped us.
L'inviata della televisione siriana Yara Saleh è rimasta per 6 giorni nelle mani di un gruppo ribelle che, come testimonia questo video, minacciava di ucciderla assieme a tutta la sua troupe.
And they decided, Al-Sheikh decided that all of us had should be killed.
Point, they, decided,
they killed the cameraman
said,
assistant.
The Sheikh decided we had to be killed.
2 hours
so
after they kidnapped us,
after
cameraman
they
was Christian,
us, they
and they forced
the
him to pray like Muslim.
Then our
they forced me to wear hijab
was
and
to pray
dress thing. They call themselves FSA, Free Syrian Army, and I saw people from Saudi Arabia with them.
They call themselves
so
the Free Syrian Army,
Syrian.
But more than
when
one
they
of
killed,
them was from Saudi Arabia.
Hatem,
I don't
the cameraman
think
assistant,
they are Syrian.
They did not
when
look to
him, the
an army law,
assistant,
you know,
they, were not
they just listened
the rules
to a sheikh.
Of any army.
So this
they
is not free, this is not Syrian, this is not
For this
army.
Reason, I
when
don't
you listen
think they
to a sheikh,
army, they
that
are not free
means
and
that
they
you are
not even Syrian. you listen to us,
and this is not the kind of the freedom that we want. It's not freedom when you force me as a woman
to force a woman like me to wear a hijab. It's not a sign of freedom.
And it's not freedom.
It's not a sign neither of freedom nor of humanity to try and rape me like
when you try to rape me.